Firefighters need boots they can pull on lightning fast to get to the blaze as quickly as possible. Those boots have to be fire-resistant, of course, and waterproof. They have to provide good grip for climbing ladders and be sturdy enough not to puncture when stepping through sharp debris. Firefighter boots start out as a chunky block of rubber. The first step is to put the block through a mill. It passes through the rollers over and over again until it gradually flattens and thins out. Workers then add chemicals, anywhere from 15 to 35 different types, depending on the model of boot they're making. The rubber formulation is what makes the boot fire-resistant. Once the rubber is smooth and malleable, about the consistency of modeling dough, they form it into sheets from which they'll cut the various pieces that make up the boot. They feed this sheet through rollers that imprint vertical lines on the rubber. They'll cut the sheet along these lines to make the strips that run down the back of the boot. From another sheet of rubber, using a handheld die, they cut one layer of the multi-layered sole. They run an extra thick sheet of rubber through rollers that imprint a tread pattern. Then workers cut out the bottom soles. They mark the boot size on the bottom. Using yellow rubber, they cut out the boot's toe cap covers. The boot's leg has a stiff lining to prevent it from wobbling. Workers cut it from a rubber-backed cotton fabric following a pattern. Once all the pieces are cut, workers can assemble the boot on a form. They start with the lining, wrapping it around the front and gluing it closed at the back. Then they glue on the insole. For this model, it's made of rubber-backed felt. They secure the lining seam and seal it with one of those rubber strips we saw earlier. Now, the vamp, a piece of felt reinforced with a thin layer of rubber. This gives the boot strength. Next, the toe cap sponge, made of rubber compounds. When they cure the boot, the sponge will inflate and hold this steel toe cap in place. To protect the firefighters' feet when walking through sharp debris, a steel arch and a steel sole. Next, an adhesive-backed toe cap cover. Then a felt sole to protect the firefighter's foot against heat. It has a steel arch for stability when the firefighter climbs the ladder. After applying a rubber heel reinforcement, they cover the lower part of the boot with yellow foam for insulation. They secure it using a strip of rubber. Now they finish the bottom of the boot in black rubber. They reinforce the back and sides in yellow rubber. And finish them off in black rubber. Next comes the yellow toe cap. Then a rubber pad to protect the front of the boot when it rubs against the rungs of the fire ladder. Now the bottom sole. They use a press to seal it in place. Rubber bonds to rubber under pressure. They apply a rubber trim around the bottom, using a small roller to press it in place. Workers then press all the seams to ensure they're well adhered. Then it's into a vacuum machine for about 4 seconds to create an airtight bond. Finally, the boots go into a giant oven that heats them to 140 degrees Celsius. An hour and 45 minutes later, the rubber is cured and hardened, and all the pieces have fused together. These boots are ready to take the heat.